Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is Engine News with the latest updates from the Angular community every week. Angular 19.2 was released, and the star feature that everyone is talking about is the experimental function httpResource, where before Angular 19, we had to trigger an HTTP request, which was based on a signal change via an effect. This changed in 19.0 with resource, but httpResource is the thing that we want to have. The HTTP resource is optimized for reactivity. That means within the URL parameter, we could use one or multiple signals, and as soon as they change, the resource starts to send out an HTTP request, and the result is stored in the resource's value, which is another signal. Resource and rxResource will stay as the building blocks for any asynchronous tasks, but because in most of the cases, an asynchronous task is an HTTP request, we will use the HTTP resource. That's also the reason why, although 19.2 is just a minor release, there was so much hype around it. Please note that HTTP resource is not a replacement for the HTTP client. In fact, it uses the HTTP client under the hood. HTTP resource is meant for fetching data. That also means that for post put delete and anything else that changes something in your backend, you should use the normal HTTP client as it was until now. HTTP resource does prefetching. This is a complete mind shift. Where in the past, an observable started its request once we subscribed to it, the HTTP resource does it already when we call it. Why? Because we want to serve data or have the data available as soon as possible. A potential big difference is also the way how we deal with types of the response. In the past with HTTP client, the type was also a generic one. With HTTP resource, there is now a parse function available where we can use libraries like sort that can do type validation during runtime and also provide the right type. We can define a default value until the first response comes back. We can also trigger the request ourselves by executing the reload method. And we can also block the prefetching by letting the URL return undefined. Careful when URL returns undefined, the reload method doesn't work. So be sure to pack the undefined value into a condition. Next to the release of version 19.2, the Angular team also published two RFCs. The first one covers the concept and what problem it tries to solve. It also discusses the alternative approach of suspense, which is based on dealing with asynchronous tasks internally and why it was not chosen. Additionally, the RFC also discusses future developments and features where the resource can be integrated, like routing, server-side loading, internal error handling, etc. It goes without saying that the resource will become a cornerstone for anything in Angular that runs asynchronously. The second RFC discusses the API, which is not just the HTTP resource, but also resource and rxResource. Be sure to read it, and the Angular team is asking actively for your feedback. There is a lot of community content about the 19.2 release. Since the chance is therefore very high that I miss someone, let's just say I mentioned some content in the previous episodes, but the primary sources are the two RFCs. And that's it. I wish you a nice week. See you in the next episode. Goodbye.